So in today's video, I'd like to cover a very serious topic, air guitaring. Air guitaring is a very serious skill that many people need to know in just everyday scenarios. You may be on the streets, you may be at a party, you may be just dancing with some friends, you may be at a family reunion, but everybody always wants to hang out with the air guitarist. But what I've noticed is anybody who does air guitar doesn't know how to do it with extreme skill and precision to make sure they get the best quality. So today I am going to be teaching you. Yes, you. I've rambled on enough. Let's get into the tutorial. There are three main steps you need to consider when you're air guitaring. One is your posture, two is the position of your arms, and three is the style. For an upbeat song, you want a straight back and a high neck so you can get into that guitar. But if you're listening to a more country or acoustic song, you can lean into it and be all like jelly-like posture because it really adds to the feel. So what you need to do is you need one hand about head length, which is holding your guitar, and then the other hand about the chest length, which is going to be strumming your guitar. For upbeat songs, there are two main steps. There's the head bop and the windmill arm. The head bop you can use while you're just like strumming normally. But then the windmill arm is when the song gets a little crazy after like a beat drop. Two moves for acoustic or lower beat songs are jelly and the bird. Jelly is when you just like get into it and it's all mellow. And then the bird is when you're accentuating a movement. So like when a certain chord or a certain sound goes for a long period of time, you pull it and whisk it away. So now to round up all of our knowledge, I'm going to be doing a performance of the Bohemian Rhapsody guitar solo. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed.